folks, Dave Schulke here with the Twin Home Experts, here to answer a question that we get often. How do I diagnose a leaking water heater, or my water heater's leaking? Where is it leaking from? Well, I'm here to go ahead and give you those tips. So the last thing you want to do is replace your water heater when it's not even leaking. So I've seen this a lot where customers assume just because they're getting water in the smitty pan, which is the pan that captures the water from spreading out, or a water heater that's leaking, it prevents damage from spreading. So a lot of times you'll see the water here. If you do, it doesn't necessarily mean that your water heater is bad. So the first step you want to do is grab yourself a ladder, and you always want to check and make sure that all of your joints, which is your hot and cold water pipes that connect to the water heater, are actually dry. And you could do this by taking your hand and wiping the joints where these flex connectors connect to the hot and cold water pipes. And as you can see, it's completely dry. Once you determine and confirm and verify that there's no leaking joints up here, then the next step is go ahead and check the water pressure to the tank. And I'll show you what that looks like right now. Now, if you do get any type of water or see any type of seepage, what typically happens is the water can go down through the water heater and seep down and fill up the pan. So very, very important that if you do get water up here, to disconnect and either replace your flex connectors, which is pretty easy to do. Turn your water back on and reconfirm. Next step you want to make sure of is this valve right here. This is what we call a temperature pressure valve. There is actually a plastic sensor that goes into this tank. And if the temperature rises to a certain degree, I think it's around 210 degrees, it's going to activate this here and release the pressure through this release line and save your water heater. So again, temperature relief valve is very critical. I've seen these a lot capped off. That is not good for your water heater. It'd be a costly mistake. So make sure that you've got a temperature release line that actually goes to the outside. A great tip to prevent your investment here from actually leaking. Again, water heater builds up. This is gonna activate and release that pressure. All right, folks, so this is a water gauge. It's got a rubber washer inside. What you're gonna do is you're gonna go ahead and screw it on the end of the hose bib that's coming out of the water heater, just like that. Then what you want to do is grab yourself some channel locks and tighten it up just so it doesn't leak. Just like that. Now, as you can see that it's reading zero. Now what we're going to do is we're going to turn the hose bib on. And as you can see, the needle just moved. We're right just a little over 50 PSI, which is perfect. Quick warning, sometimes these hose bibs that come out of the water heater aren't in the best shape. They're made of plastic or they're rusted out, very vulnerable to leaking. So if you have a valve that just doesn't look like you just don't want to touch it, let me show you another place that's just as effective. All right, folks, so if your water heater hose bib just doesn't look like a good fit to put a gauge, another alternative getting the same results is just find a hose bib that's actually on the hot and cold water system. So this is the domestic water line. You don't want to put it on your sprinkler lines, but this here is the cold water that feeds the same water heater. So by putting it on here and checking pressure, checking for expansion is going to give you the same result. So again, if we come over to here, you could see that we're going to get the same water pressure right at 50. And again, if you're checking for expansion, meaning confirming that your expansion tank is working, or if your home has expansion issues, make sure that the water to the house is off, meaning nobody's using the water. And just keep an eye on this gauge. If it starts to creep up, then you know you have an expansion problem. All right, folks, so now that we've got pressure and we've also turned off the valve on top of the water heater, if you start to see this needle right here start to drop going towards zero, you know that you've got a leak on the hot side. Go ahead and make sure that all of your faucets on your hot side are not dripping. But more than likely, if this is dropping, it is the water heater that is leaking. Well, folks, hopefully this gave you some tips and tricks that you can do on a water heater leaking. As always, thanks for watching.